Hi everybody, how is your spiritual life going? I'll bet you know it's connected with your prayer life because it's a relationship with God. You gotta spend time with God to know His presence, to hear His voice, to feel the knowledge and love coming from Him towards others. We live by it. Therefore, the more we're connected to God in prayer, the better our spiritual lives can be. Now, I know it's actually what you have to do is take God with you everywhere you go, and absolutely life is to be a prayer. No question about that. You just don't leave it in the bedroom or your prayer closet. But I find that how well I connect with God throughout the day really does depend upon my private time with prayer. And Jesus and the disciples are a pretty biblical example, so I think we'll go with that as a pretty much necessity. What I think is really a great way to do it is variety. Get some variety in your life. Even variety of posture. My first prayer in the morning is to stand giving praise of adoration to God. Now, I don't feel like it at first often, but it does get me warmed up, and I feel His presence. You will too, like you do in church. And it's just focusing on His goodness. There isn't a request to be thought of. And then at some point later, you might recite some prayers, either the Lord's Prayer or petitions that you have. And it's really great, of course, to be praying for others and really just have a moment. Don't belabor it, because He does know what's going on. So you don't have to make it too much of a labor. Just keep it brief and to the point, and just have your heart positioned for whoever you are praying for. Later on in the day, in the middle of the day, I think it's great to connect with God, and you don't have much time. I think crafted prayers are the way to go. And the liturgy developed in the Anglican, Catholic, and Lutheran churches and Orthodox churches over the centuries is a great resource. I recommend the Oxford Book of Prayer. I was so enthused when I first read that about 15 or 20 years ago. I sent it to all my relatives. It was brilliant. I still use choice prayers that I picked out today in the middle of my day where I can just meditate briefly on some well-written prayers. And then, of course, you can have even the liturgical prayers where you go through the long office of what Anglicans or Catholics will do, and it's brilliant as well. Really good stuff there. Also, you can, of course, use Pray As You Go app or any other app that may have a nice little service where you get a little song and a little bit of a scripture reading and a nice walkthrough message or reflection. That is fantastic as well. Of course, many of you will just use your Bible, which is what you should do as well. You open the Psalms up, that is the book of songs to God and prayers, and you make them your own by reading choice portions that reflect in some way what your heart is yearning for. And don't worry about the details. Make it personal. Make it first person as you do it, and that will make your prayers come alive. And also, I like to do at night is to kneel and reflect on the day and take these times to be humble. A humble and contrite heart the Lord does not despise. And He loves it when you bring your true self to Him and know that you've got nothing to give Him, but He is your sufficiency. Be kneeling before Him to recognize that He is everything to you, and be repentant for whatever you can be, because there's no point in posturing yourself before Him. He knows what's going on. Pour out your soul to Him. Pour out your troubles. And that is a way to pray as well. So in all these things, there's such a variety of ways you can approach God in prayer. The silent prayer, the breath prayer that I have taught elsewhere. You just be silent before Him and just be present with Him. And that is a wonderful way to spend your time. So in all of this, you can be praying at specific times during your day, and I highly recommend that. Anywhere between 5 and 7 times a day, and there's scriptures for that, that you should be doing prayer or set aside times with God, and it just makes your spiritual life hum along nicely, I would say. Bless you in doing that.